You can turn off your camera, and or you don't have to answer if you don't want to be recorded. And you'll be able to view them back later. So if you miss a lesson, then you'll live on. If you are very bored, you can already look back at lessons from previous years if you really feel like it. That's some dedication. Finally, we'll also include the booklet. At the end of each booklet, of each lesson, there are two things. You have homework, which we expect you to do next week, and we have a word list of words that are may or may not be relevant for the lesson. Unfortunately, since the lessons are pretty short, 90 minutes, which might not feel short, but it is pretty short as far as language lessons go, and it's only once a week, we have to kind of pick our poisons and choose the things we want to focus on every lesson. That means that we can't do a lot of vocabulary because vocabulary takes a lot of time to tell you the words and for you to memorize the words and blah, blah, blah. Words take a long time. But in general, adults, so science, are pretty good at learning words, way better than toddlers. So you're way better. Good job. And to facilitate you learning words, we will make like a du apparently you can do that in Duolingo. We can be a teacher and we can give you assignments to do things to learn wor more words. That is completely optional and we'll put instructions how to do that during the break. But hopefully that will kind of fill the gap that we have given our limited time. Again, we are volunteers. We can't stand here for 3 hours. Whoops. Last thing that I want to no. We'll get to that now. What do we expect from you? Your dedication and enthusiasm, of course. Which means be here. Good job, you're here. If you are here, so this is just very negatively, but let's put it positively because it's nicer. If you attend at least 9 classes, including the final one, you will get a certificate signed by the ESN and someone from the UU that says you did the course. Very nice. Unfortunately, we can't put on that it is A1 or B1 because we need a certificate for learning. We can't have it. But it does say that you did an intermediate course and that you are good at Dutch. This requirement can be a bit lessened if you are consistent in telling us when you can't come, because then we know you and then we will be nicer. The final thing that isn't on here that we don't expect, but it would be nice if you would be so kind, some people already do, to turn on your camera. It makes teaching and learning for the rest a lot nicer because we will be able to see, and it will be as like talking to a black screen for us, which will make us teach better. And maybe for you, you'll see who the hell is in your course. Completely optional. Please don't feel pressured to if you, I don't know, just feel like chilling in your pajamas or whatever. But it is highly appreciated. Cool.
Thomas, we have in the chat someone who can't access the team group.
You cannot access the
Yeah,
team.
she's writing from the computer from someone else.
Oh, the Gabriella. Oh, okay. Another Gabriella. Oh, okay.
No, so
Wait.
Sophia.
Oh, Sophia. Okay. Okay. That is very good that you mentioned this. Okay. Wait. What if you do the next thing? I will add her.
Yeah. Okay. So today we're gonna do a quick recap on the subjects we think you already know, or we expect you to already know. First, some short lines: how to introduce yourself. So kennismaken. It's about who you, how you say how you what's your name and where are you from. Then just quickly something about the present simple, the tegenwoordige tijd, and the articles, the defined articles, de and het, the modal verbs, and after that, just a quick exercise, speed dating, where you can introduce yourself to other students with the basic sentences you learn. They're also in your booklet at page 6. There are some basic sentences how to introduce yourself. We expect you to already know these sentences a bit, But you can use them later on during the speed dating. After the speed dating, we'll have a short break. So the break will be switched. This break will be after the oefening. Pause will be after the oefening. And after break, we'll go on with the meervoud, kloktijden, verleden tijd and the vragen. So the plural, telling the time, the past simple and questions. Also a short recap. And when we've finished that, we'll do a bigger group assignment, which is called Two Truths and a Lie. And hopefully we'll be able to do this all in, well, 1 hour and 15 minutes. And otherwise, maybe just 5 minutes longer. We'll see how it goes. Thomas, did it work to add Sophia there? Yes?
Yes, she should be added by now. If not, then let me know. Okay. She should be visible now.
Great. Are we going to do the Kahoot? Or yes. Is it too much time?
We'll make it. Although, maybe we can... Okay, so we will do this sporadically, meaning kind of randomly, usually throughout the course. Have a Kahoot and quiz you about something. For now, we just want to get to know you a bit better and also have the other students kind of know who you are, who's everyone here. And normally in the class, we would just go by everyone, ask them about what they do, blah, 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 blah. But that will take a lot of time, practice has taught us. So instead, we will artificially speed it up through the use of everyone's favorite quiz application, Kahoot, which I will share with you now. So if you would please navigate either on your phone or on some other internet-capable device to kahoot.it and type in this code, you should be able to join a quiz. And it's not a quiz, it's more of a poll, you know.
Is your sound on, Thomas? Because Kahoot can only be played with a nice sound.
Oh, do you not hear the sound?
No.
Maybe.
But if it doesn't work, then it's okay. Or
I thought I shared it with Sam. Just let me try to share it again. If you see the, okay, quickly.
No, but.
All right. Well,
okay, well, so it's a problem. No, okay, it's a problem. How many people do we?
I can hum the sound if you want. Dun, dun.
Nice.
Glad we have $90 Fortnite card in our midst. Yes, we are with 18. 16 in the thing. Always a few people who you're learning. Oh, 50 now. What left our browser? To 40 now. It's going great. Okay, something is going wrong. Show conversation. Someone is having trouble or... Thank you for letting me see what you mean for sure. Oh, okay. Farewell. Someone from my beginner's course wants to check out the advanced course, intermediate course. Okay.
I think we can start.
Yes, you can still join even though the thing has started, but you'll just miss being able to answer one question or something. So never fear. It's not for credit. Also, the assignments in between are not for credit. I needed to mention that for legal reasons. Not for legal reasons. All right, first one. Eerste. Waar kom je vandaan? Lekker makkelijk.
Hello. So the first question... Hopefully, so it's in Dutch, so hopefully you understand the question. It's, where are you from?
Okay. My laptop fell. It still works. All right. So, Zuid-Afrika, Italië, mijn huis. Hey, good job. Giving out crucial information. Indonesië, Amerika, Hongarije. Ah, multiple people came from Hungary. Cool, cool, cool. I think that means if it's bigger. Oh, okay. Let's go on. If it's bigger, I think more people come from it. Ik kom uit München. Nice. München. I won't plan to know German. Duitsland, Spanje, Argentinië en Bulgarije. Heel cool. Heel cool.
Nice. Right.
En dan de volgende vraag. Waar woon je nu? Woon je nog in Utrecht? Of bezoek je ons vanuit Bulgarije? Oh, look at these quick answers. Okay. See one big block. What could it be, possibly?
Utrecht.
With the vrouwen, Glasgow, Den Haag and Utrecht. Yes. Okay, so most of you are still in Utrecht. Nice. Cool. I can wave to you from my window. Very good, very good. Volgende vraag. Wat studeer je? It's a bit more varied answer, but one that also should not be too difficult. Okay, so I'm a bit more in frame. Cool. Oh, okay, cool. We're already done. Very good. Oh, no, we don't know. It just starts making the thing. Yeah, unfortunately, I only have 20 words, so 20 letters.
Yeah.
I will skip now. Sorry for the person who is still typing in their answer. HU, ik studeer muziek, rechten, sustainability science, wiskunde, cool. MBA, recht, natuurkunde, fysica, two people studying physics and one math, nice. Mm-hmm.
Strafrecht, denk ik.
Strafrecht, ah, yes. Duits, Frans studies, business, geschiedenis, een masterdiploma.
Nice.
Ah. I also used to study physics before I did history and philosophy science, so I always feel some kindredness. Very cool. Rechten, a lot of people doing law, MBA. I think that's also law now. I don't know. Sorry, that sounds probably really dumb that I don't know that. MBA. Master of business? No. Okay, I don't know. I'm done embarrassing myself. Let's move on to... Or maybe someone wants to educate me in the chat. Welke ervaring met de Nederlandse taal heb je? What experience do you have learning Dutch already? Since you're all from such varied backgrounds usually, from the intermediate course, did you do the beginner's course? Did you do some other course? Do you just feel like you can wing it because you're German? Or
maybe Dutch family or something like that?
The answers are varied.
Mm-hmm. Or you've just watched a lot of Dutch movies, I don't know. It's all possible.
You aced Duolingo 3 times.
So. Yeah.
Cool. Right, skip it already. Let's see. Ah, beginner's course, cool. Afrikaans and Duolingo, nice. Dutch dad, alleen Duolingo, een beginner's course. Duolingo en ASN les, nice. ESN beginner's course.
Zondag met Lubach, that's
Zondag
great.
Zondag met Lubach, ah, that's very cool. Some basic nice. Knowledge, basic Dutch course, Nederlandse vriend, en een A2 cursus. Okay, cool, cool, cool. So pretty varied backgrounds, but I think we're indeed all kind of on a good same level.
Yeah.
Wat wil je leren? So what is one, you only have 20 words, letters. So what's one thing you would like to be able to do after this? And try to be like very specific. Like have a good conversation. That might fit in 20 letters. Other things might not. I'll just quiz you a bit about this afterwards. Maybe you want to be fluent after this. Probably won't, but maybe you want to. Okay. Let us see. Betere grammatica, de werkwoorden. Order beer in bar. Een goed gesprek. Spreken. Communicatie. Spreken Nederlands. Flirten. Hey, ik wil beter praten. Nice. Hele goede antwoorden. Betere grammatica, daar komen we sowieso bij. We'll definitely get a better grammar. And verbs, we'll also do. And talking, hopefully, we'll get to this lesson if we don't spend too much time on spitting through your questions. Flirting, the final lesson's theme is going on a date. Where we will teach you all we know about flirting, which is so much. Oh, ooh. Nice. Okay, 6. So, from your previous experience, welke onderwerpen vond je lastig? Which topics did you find very different to tackle? Yeah. Which are difficult to learn? The verbs? Oh, there's a damn. Figuring out which words are doing head.
Yeah.
Is het deze vraag beantwoorden? Answering this question? That is pretty good. Alright, let's see what you came up with. Word endings. Haha, de headwoorden, woordkennis, getallen. Ah. Pronunciation. Ah, very cool. I really like talking about pronunciation, so we can.
So, for example, Scheveningen. That's.
Scheveningen.
Gonna, hopefully, at the end of the course, you can all say Scheveningen.
88 prachtige grachten. Werkwoorden, woordvolgorde. And we spend a lot of time on this course. So, grammatica, nice. Woorden, woordkennis, woorden. Words, they're difficult. They also make up most of language, so we'll get to those. Nice. Word clouds. And finally, the fun icebreaker question. What's your guilty pleasure? What is jouw guilty pleasure, Evelien?
Ik heb er heel lang over nagedacht en ik kon echt niks bedenken. Ik dacht gewoon een basic antwoord chocola, maar dat...
Dat is heel bezig. Zei ik vorige keer ook. Ja. En nu zat ik te denken, en ik... Nu niet echt meer, maar ik vond de Chainsmokers een tijdje echt heel, echt te leuk. Okay. Voor hoe goed ze zijn.
Ja, op zich. Ja, oké.
Okay. Daar was ik wel guilty over.
Het zou erger zijn, nice. Het zou erger zijn
RuPaul's
als je...
Drag Race, awesome. You don't need to feel guilty about that.
K3. Nice.
De wink. Wine. Awesome. K3, that is a very great answer. I have not thought about K3 for so long. K3, for those who don't know, is the most famous Dutch pop group amongst children. They're very good. Okay, good. Thank you for participating. And let us move on to learning. Although we did a lot of learning about ourselves. And now we're just learning about Dutch. Okay. Every time I share my screen, I lose you. Okay. So we just did this. We'll get to that in a bit. Evelien.
Yeah. So now we're just the basics, which you probably already know. So hebben en zijn, dit zijn hele belangrijke werkwoorden. really important because you use them a lot. As you can see, the plural forms for wij, jullie en zijn, zij zijn allemaal hetzelfde, gewoon hebben of zijn. Dus de infinitief, zo de het hele werkwoord. But you have to pay attention to the I form or the you or he, she, it. Die drie vormen, the first three, you have to just have in your mind. But I think you already know these because it's really basic. So een voorbeeld zien. De leraar heeft geen geduld. Dan is heeft, de leraar is een hij. So hij heeft geen geduld. It's the third row. En dan hij is 3000 jaar oud, which is very old. So I probably think, won't think he is that old. It would be better if you just say, ik ben 20 jaar oud. And in those sentences, or ik ben een student. In the most basic sentences you use hebben en zijn. So I think you already know these forms.
Yes.
So let's move on, I think.
Yeah, let's move on from this atrocious formatting to better formatting, next.
Yeah, de en het. So the articles. Nederlands heeft twee definite articles en Engels heeft er maar eentje. In English you only have the. En hier hebben we de en het. And you can see the rules. There are no general rules, but there are some specific rules for which you can learn. But you have to just feel it. But here are some basic rules. You can also find these rules in your booklet. And for example, the fifth rule of het. You can only use the fifth rule with two syllables, when a word is two syllables. So het begin or het verkeer. So you can't use it for example the radio, because radio has radio, has three syllables. So you don't say het radio, you say de radio.
Yeah.
In those cases, so that's an that's very important to remember. And the other rules, yeah, you can learn them. And for de, there also are some rules about the meervoudsvorm, de drankjes, de mensen. You always use de for the meervoud. En als je naar mens verwijst, dus de bakker, de koning. But
de
only
leraar.
De leraar, precies. But for example, when you're saying het staatshoofd, which is also de koning, you use het because je combineert twee woorden met elkaar. Staat en hoofd. En dan gebruik je het. Dus ga gewoon uit van de basics. So use the basic people. When you're talking about people, say de koning in plaats van het staatshoofd. Remember, that's way easier.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, maybe another good illustration of this rule is what we are doing right now. We're having a meeting. Meeting in Dutch is vergadering. So it also starts with ver. Maar het heeft vier lettergrepen. Vergadering. And so it is de. Well, that's not why it is de, but it is not het. So it is de vergadering. Well, het verkeer is two syllables. So it is het.
Yes.
The other ones, if it is a diminutive, it ends with je. Then you have het, isme, and aat. Those are the only...
Specifics.
Yeah, only things you can rely on. Otherwise, you need to drill those things.
Yeah.
Good way to do that. Always write down, if you're learning a word, write down if it's de or het. You don't even per se have to like look at it later. If you just write it down, you'll remember better. Pedagogy, you know?
Yeah, regelmatige werkwoorden, so the regular verbs. Yes?
Did you just say that fair is de vergadering or het?
De.
De vergadering.
Because in the previous slide, I thought I said if it starts with a ver, then it's a het word.
If it's two syllables.
Oh, got you.
So, yeah.
Thanks.
Nice. Okay, great. Good question. So let's move on. The regular verbs. So these are like the basic verbs. And daarvoor gebruik je de stam. Voor bijvoorbeeld gaan. Het werkwoord gaan is een regelmatig werkwoord. En ook hier zie je de meervoudsvormen wij, jullie en zij. Allemaal hetzelfde en allemaal gaan. En bij de ik, jij en hij vorm moet je de stam moet je nog vervoegen. Daar zal Thomas nu wat meer over zeggen uit de present simple, tegenwoordig tijd. En how to use the crude stem.
Yeah, let's conjugate some verbs. So in the tegenwoordig tijd, you probably know how to do this. So the, again, apologies for the formatting. Google Slides and PowerPoint don't really work well together. The basic rules for conjugation in the present simple in Dutch is very simple. I hate the joke. Is you have the stem, and then for the first person singular, you have stem. For the second person singular, you have the stem plus t. And for the third person singular, you have stem plus t. And then you just have the infinitive. Cool. Ik studeer Nederlands. That's what you are doing. Very good. But I hear you ask, but Thomas, how do I make the stem? That is very complicated. And it can be. But first, let's briefly go over when you use this. Let's just go somewhere with better formatting. Sorry, I just can't stand it. Use the present simple in a few cases. Well, that's okay. Sorry. Sorry for switching slides, but there are four cases when you use the present simple in Dutch. We use it a lot more than in English. In English, you like using the present continuous a lot more. I am working right now, so whatever. And in Dutch, we use the present simple more to like refer to things that happen right now. So what do you there, Jantje? Ik doe mijn huiswerk. I'm doing my homework. So in English, you would use I'm doing instead of ik do. Refer to ongoing habitual or repetitive state, action or state. So things that are like happening all the time. 'S ochtends sta ik om 4 uur op en ren dan een marathon om wakker te worden. So in the morning, I wake up at 4 and run a marathon to wake up. So in English, you also use present simple for that. I refer to a future event that is pretty certain. So morgen regent het. Tomorrow it will rain. Bah. Bleh. Or to refer to hypothetical if-then situations. Als het regent, ren ik maar een halve marathon. If it rains, I'll only run half a marathon. Such a slacker. But then, how do you make the stem? So there's a difference between the stem and what we call the crude stem. And often these are kind of mishmashed together, but if you don't keep them separate, things get messy. So the crude stem is just the infinitive, like kopen, to buy, and you chop off the en at the end. And so you get here, you get kop. But that is not the same as the stem. If you want to get the stem of the word, you have to apply the Dutch spelling rules, which are these three, namely that vowel sounds get conserved, in this case, long ones. You don't have double consonants or vowels at the end of words, meaning the same, not just double. You can have more than one consonant after each other. It's not Japanese. And at the end of syllables, a Z becomes an S and a V becomes an F. So here we have kopen. If we want to conjugate that like a naive fool, we just chop off en and we think, oh, we have the stem, cool. But no, we want to conserve this vowel sound because kopen, so it's very different than kop. This is pronounced kop. So we add another O, kope, ik koop. No double consonants at the end because those are superfluous. Here, stemmen, which we will do in 2 weeks. If you chop off the en, you get ik stem, which is not the stem, but the crude stem. Funny joke. And if you want to get the crude stem, you chop off one of the m's because we don't need it. So we get ik stem with one m. Or stan. There's no en to chop off, so we just chop off the n. And then we have two a's at the end. It's too many a's. We only need one. Ik sta. And then finally with Z and S's and V's and F, in Dutch we really don't like having Z's and V's at the end of words. It's very difficult. In fact, we don't even like having voiced consonants at the end of words at all. So if you might have noticed that Dutch people, if they have a D at the end, like in the word dood, death or dead, you don't say dood, but you say dood with a T. Because we just pronounce it like an unvoiced syllable. The difference between voiced and unvoiced syllables will be relevant for later. Voiced syllables, you use your voice box, and unvoiced, you don't. The difference is very clear with the Z and the S. So if you say Z, you have your voice box vibrating. And with an S, you don't feel anything here. And in Dutch, we like the latter ones a lot more. So here you have reizen. The stem is ik reis, not ik reis. Durven, it becomes ik durf, not ik durf. And if you use that to create the stem, then you can use that stem in this little thingy to conjugate your verb. Cool. Good job. You relearned how to conjugate a Dutch verb. Then, well, this really, really went horribly. So let's not look at that slide, but instead look at your booklet on page, I don't know, on the modal verb page, where we talk about the modal verbs. Modal verbs change the attitude of the sentence. And you already got to know about them. They are like may, have to, want. Is able yeah. to, and shall. Those are the five.
At page six.
Page six. They are very nice. You already probably know how to use them in English, and so you probably know how to use them in Dutch. What you need to know is that in English, you put the infinitive that the modal verb replaces, you put it after the normal verb. So if you say, I go to school, then you just say that. But if you say, I want to go to school, then you put the go after the go after the want to. Someone has a question. Hi, Anna.
Hey, I don't have the booklet yet. I thought they were gonna send it online, but it never arrived. Should I email someone?
Ah, that's very good, and I should have mentioned that. You can see the booklet in Teams if you go to the general channel and you click on files and then class materials, then the booklet will be there. Thanks for mentioning that.
Yeah, great, thanks.
Yeah, so instead, in the difference between English is you put the infinitive after the main verb, so I want to go to school, and in Dutch you put the infinitive all the way at the end of the sentence. That's a general rule. All the infinitives go to the end of the sentence. Get them out of here. So instead of saying, so the normal sentence is ik ga naar school, I'm going to school, and the modal version is ik wil naar school gaan. So the gaan is all the way at the end. Ta-da! You relearned how to do modal verbs. Good job. And again, this is kind of quick, very quick, because it's more of a refresher of, hey, these are things you might already know, rather than a full explanation of everything. If you are interested in a full explanation of everything, you can check out the beginner's course booklet, which is in the same place, and it has explanations of all these topics in much more detail than we can cover in like one lesson here. Rest assured that the rest of the course will be much more in depth, because we can treat just one topic. But now that you have relearned a bit of your Dutch knowledge, we are going to immediately put it into practice by having you converse with one another for a brief amount of time. Also to kind of get to know each other a bit more and to just kind of practice your general chit-chat skills. On the page, from the top of my head, page 4 of your booklet, there are some things like general introduction things like...
Almost, page 5.
Okay. Hoe heet je? Waar kom je vandaan? Wat zijn je dingen? Wat zijn je hobby's? Etc. And you will practice these with one another and try to do it completely in Dutch. Even though it just goes horribly wrong, try to stick to Dutch and just chat about these things for a couple of minutes. After that, I'll yank you all back and then put you in a meeting again and then yank you back and put you in a meeting again. And that will be the exercise for now. Sound good? You don't have to do anything for this, but talk. I hear no objections. So I'll make the rooms. I've learned from the previous one that I should keep talking and not say bye until the rooms are opening. Otherwise, it'll leave an awkward silence. But they will be opening soon. So good luck. See you in a bit. Fuck, I didn't time it right. Okay, ooh, now everyone's gone. Hi.
Hi, I'm sorry, just that I had the microphone off and I had to go out and enter again to activate it.
Oh. Okay, do you know which room you were in?
No.
Okay. Let's see if I can find you.
Sorry.
No worries, no worries. Did you get assigned to a room?
Yeah, but I don't remember which one it was. I think there is one room with just one girl, so I should be in there.
Yeah, you should, but I don't see it. Like, I'll just put you in a room.
Room three, I was.
Room three. Oh, okay. Oh, yeah. Now I see it. Great. Right. Right.
Okay.
Oh, I don't know. This is difficult. Her. It says you are in the room. That is very confusing.
Oh, I don't see that.
No, maybe you are clearly not in the room. Okay, I will. Yeah, I will close the room.
Ah, no, wait, wait.
You figured that part. Okay, I panicked, so. Yeah, sorry for rudely interrupting your conversation. Next time I will give a brief heads up.
Sorry.
Things went wrong with someone else, so I just brought you all back, and I will assign you all once again, once teams.
Better.
Yeah, sorry again for rudely interrupting. Okay, so there you go. Hopefully you'll be randomly assigned someone new. If you meet the same person, you can just continue your chat. Creating rooms. Yeah, it always has to fail once. Okay, let's see. This will go very well. Timing, okay. Good luck.
Nope.
Just too soon. Okay, now you're all leaving.
Just pulls us back.
Hello.
Holy.
Welcome back.
Why do you keep interrupting?
This thing works. And did you get a message saying I am 1 minute? Or was it just rudely interrupting? Yes? Okay, cool. Fantastic. Well, given the amount of time that we have left, we'll leave the speed day sessions at that for now. Don't worry, you'll have more time to meet your fellow classmates in the final exercise of this lesson. For now, we will have a break until 9. Just before that, I will briefly mention the Duolingo thing and show how you can use it. So here, where is it? Yeah, block. Mm-hmm. Cool. Yeah, there it is. Going too fast. Yes, I hope this is a bit legible. See you moving closer. So on Duolingo, you can follow this link. This thing is also in the files on this channel, so if this is illegible, go there. So either follow the rightmost link or go into your app and enter ZGGGFP somewhere. Okay? That's very clear. What it will do is we can send you assignments every week and check if you did them and then monitor your progress, and then we can fight amongst each other to see who is the best in Dutch. Okay. And that is it for now.
Which class should we join?
The rightmost, class 10.
Oh, class 10.
Okay. Yes. Okay, and we will have break until 9 now. And see you back here for more Dutch.
I'm doing selling.
Nou, dat wordt wel krap zometeen, Thomas.
Ja, dat wordt krap. Ja, drie minuten per persoon is toch wel heel erg kort.
Ja, dat is zeker, ja. Mm-hmm. Maar het is wel grappig om te zien, want ik had dus net ook al twee gesprekjes met twee mensen. Mm-hmm. Om gewoon het niveau ook een beetje af te tasten.
Ja, hoe was het?
Ja, dat is wel echt. Maar je ziet echt een verschil, hoor. Want eentje die kan heel goed Nederlands al. Mm-hmm. Heeft ook al gewoon A2 level gehaald. Dus die had een bepaald niveau. En die andere heeft een beginnerscourse gevolgd vorig semester. Mm-hmm. Dus die merkt wel dat ze echt allemaal heel enthousiast zijn ook gewoon om verder te gaan.
Ja, dat is heel erg fijn om te horen.
Ja. Maar dan zo meteen moeten we kijken. We moeten kijken of we 10 minuten misschien redden om die rest van de informatie even doorheen te
douwen.
Ja, het is heel krap, maar ik weet niet of het hoe uitgebreid we dan stil moeten staan daarbij allemaal. Want
ja, even gewoon gokje. Skip plurals gewoon. Zeg gewoon, dat staat in het boekje.
Ja.
Klok kijken. Kan je heel even overheen gaan? Gewoon even ook mentionen dat er twee manieren zijn om dingen uit te spreken. Tot 20 over en 10 over half.
Ja.
En wat had je, welk andere ding had je nog meer?
Nee, ik had alleen de klok kijken en de plurals. En zou dan nog de de questions en past verleden tijd en zo doen.
Ja, en dat kan wel. Dat kan wel 5 minuten.
Ja.
De questions is heel makkelijk en de andere dingen zijn heel...
Ja, precies.
Ja. Bij mensen aan voor die vragen. Dat is ook wel goed. We hebben niet zoveel interaction. We hebben wel soort van interaction, maar... Het is wel moeilijk voor mij om te judgen hoe de oefening gaat als ik ze allemaal naar die breakout room stuur en ik ga er niet in lurken.
Nee, snap ik. Dus dat is, ja. Maar dat moeten we misschien dan bij die twee leugens en één waarheid. Of twee waarden en één leugen. Dan misschien wel eventjes. Alleen als jij mij ook in een breakout... Ik kom ook in een breakout room terecht dan natuurlijk.
Ja, maar die twee leugens, één waarheid, die kunnen we sowieso niet wat makkelijk opdelen. Want we hebben nu 17 mensen. Dus dat is sowieso niet netjes. Dus dan... We kunnen 4 groepen van 4 doen. Of 5 groepen... 6 groepen van... vijf groepen van drie. Nee, wacht. Drie groepen van drie en twee van vier.
Drie groepen van drie, twee van vier. Ja. Nee. Drie groepen van drie. Ja, ja, klopt. Ja, ja. Dan zou ik dat inderdaad doen. En dan moet je alleen even kijken als je mij. Als je dat, want ik word ook meteen ingedeeld natuurlijk dan. Of niet?
Ja, want als we dan.
Kan je dat uitzetten?
Nee, volgens mij niet. Ja, ik kan mensen manually assignen, maar dat.
Nee, oké. Okay. Maar dan zou ik het gewoon verlaten dan, als ik het denk ik. Maar moeten we wel hopen dat diegene wel genoeg mensen erin hebben zitten natuurlijk.
Ja, wat ik wel kan doen is gewoon alvast die groepen. Ik kan die groepen nu alvast maken en dan pas de kamers openen als ze er zijn. Dus.
Oké, okay, als dat niet te veel gedoe is dan.
Nee, ik kan gewoon nu manually, gewoon randomly mensen zijn en jou eruit halen.
Oké. Okay.
Denk ik. Dus we hebben 18 mensen, behalve ik. Dus dat zijn als we zes groepen doen.
Nee, ja, ik zit
er. Er doen vijf groepen, ja.
Er zijn 17, volgens mij min ons twee 17.
Ja, dus we doen vijf groepen, ja.
Ja.
Oké. Okay. Ik weet niet meer of ik, als ik mensen randomly assign, of ik het dan nog wel mensen uit kan halen. Oké, okay, dus jij zit nu in een groep. Ja, jij zit in een groep van vier. Wat zit je in? Evelien. Ah, nee, je zit in een groep van drie.
Oh, shit.
Maar ik kan je er wel. Dan kan je de assignen en dan kan ik je unassign maken. En dan kan ik iemand uit groep 1. En dan kan ik ze ook even leuke namen geven. Want, die kan ik dan assignen naar groep 5. Haha. En dan ga ik ze ook even namen geven. Ik doe gewoon de ESN kleuren.
Ja, precies.
Heb ik die ergens hier? Ja. Dus groep 1 is.
Oranje. Dan.
Groep 2 is.
Groen.
Dat was eigenlijk een classic Dutch iets dat we eigenlijk wel moeten leren. Dat als iemand groen zegt, dan ben je wettelijk verplicht om daarna te zeggen groen. dan blauw eigenlijk is het. Nee, dat is cyaan.
Nou, dat wordt iets te lastig.
Ja. Lichtblauw en donkerblauw.
Ja, anders doe je gewoon blauw en dan doe je die donkerblauw en maak je een rood of zo, of geel.
Nee, dat kan niet.
Oh.
Oké, okay, nou, dat maakt wel meer sens. Dan doen we gewoon die maken we geel.
Ja, precies.
En dan hebben we...
Roze.
Magenta, als de fancy wil doen, maar dat willen we niet. Ik vind roze ook een accent of zo. Ik heb het gevoel dat het een accent heeft.
Nee.
Ja. En blauw.
Yes.
Blauw klinkt, is niet echt een hele mooi klinkende.
Nee, het klinkt zo hard blauw.
Komt echt door die L.
Ja.
Ik zat aan het begin van van lettergrepen klinkt de L anders dan ergens anders in het woord.
Klopt, ja.
Ja, halter, ja. En later.
Ja.
Ik wist het niet eerst. Okay. Oh. Okay.
Is het gelukt met die teams, ja?
Is gelukt met het?
Met die teams die je nu hebt gemaakt, ja? Voor zometeen?
Ja, ik had ze gewoon erin voor je zometeen.
Ja, top.
Ja, dat is nice, want ik kan gewoon op start rooms klikken. En dan...
Alleen bij de, zeg maar, in de, hoe heet dat? Kahoot zit nog wel een zesde groep erbij, zeg maar.
Ah ja, we skippen nog gewoon.
Ja, oké. Okay. Het is nu 9:00.
Oh ja, dan moeten we starten. We zijn hard. Ik ben niet hard. Maar we doen hard. Okay. So, it's 9 o'clock, so we will continue. With. Oh. It looks like shit. Okay. Here we are.
Yes.
Take it away.
Yeah.
Welcome back, everyone.
Short the plurals, you can look them up in your booklets. We're not gonna repeat the meervoudsvormen. It's their basic rules and you can just find them in your booklet. So we're gonna continue with klokkijken. And klokkijken is, you probably already know it, very No, well, there are some basics. You can see the picture. Maar het is belangrijk dat er twee manieren zijn bij het klokkijken. Je ziet 5 over, 10 over en 15 over. En dan gaat het naar 10:30 en 17:30. Dus stel het is, for example, it's 10:12. You say 10:12. Maar als je zegt 10:30, dan kan je ook zeggen 20:12. So you can say 10:12, but you can also say 20:12 in Dutch. And well, 20:12, that's what you say in English. But in Dutch, you usually say 10 minutes before 12:30. What? So in this example, you can say 10:40, but you can also say 12:20. Because you can say 10:12, you can say 11:45. So you can also say 20:12. That's like the basics. And so you can also say 20:12 at the other side and 10:12. But usually the most people in Dutch say 10:30 and 10:30. So we go like for the half of the clock. So we praten over de helft van de klok eigenlijk. Dus voor de half, 10:30 en niet over het uur wat geweest is. Dus ja. Dat is eigenlijk, maar het kan dus op twee manieren. So you can talk it two ways, but you have to remember that most Dutch people use the forms like in the slide. So 10:30, 15:30, but and 15:30 and 10:30. But you can also say 20 over of 25 over of 20:40 of 25:40.
Yeah. So in maybe to summarize that briefly, in Dutch we just have a weird way to talk about the clock. So sometimes we say 10:50 when we want to say 12:20, because we like being difficult. You can pick what you want, 10:50 or 12:20, but most people say 10:50. So it's good to know that it exists. But the other version is just as correct. It's more of a regional difference.
Yeah.
So maybe let's see how well this goes.
Yeah. I will ask someone to tell which time it is at the first clock. Maybe Anna Dirkswager, can you tell us which time it is at the first clock?
Tien uur.
Ja, klopt.
Super.
Dat is gewoon het hele uur, gewoon helemaal rond. Goed zo. De tweede klok zou Jacob Schreuder. Can you tell us which time it is at the second clock?
Het is 4:05.
Ja, klopt. Helemaal. Goed zo. En hier zie je dus, ja, het is 4:05. En dat is gewoon wat wij zeggen. En dan zeggen we 10 minuten later is het 4:05. Dan de laatste klok zou Marina Dobreva. Can you tell us which time it is at the last clock?
10:30.
Ja, 10:30.
Yes, very good.
But you can also say here 12:20. Dus 12:20. That's also possible. Maar in het algemeen zeggen we 12:10 in plaats van 12:20.
Yes. All right, great. Very good. You know how to tell time. But what if things happen in the past? De verleden tijd. Wow, very good segue. So the past simple in Dutch is relatively simple. Yeah, I'm doing it again. Here it says simply, it is the stem plus D-E or N or T-E-N. So here, voor werken. Hij werkte gisteren achter de bar en wij kenden dat woord nog niet. He worked behind the bar yesterday, or we didn't know that word yet. So, very easy, but when do you use the D and the T? Well, it is if the last letter of the crude stem, so the just the infinitive minus en, ends in a consonant that is in sexy soft ketchup. That's the alliteration we'll use here. It's not alliteration, the, I don't know, the remembering thing. Or you can have het fokschaap in Dutch, het fokschip, or ecstasy coffee shop. Those are the other three. Pick your poison, we'll use sexy soft ketchup because it sounds funny. And so if that is the case, if you have the crude stem and you chop off en, and it ends in one of these consonants, then you add t-en, and if not, then you add d-en. So we can see that in the previous slide. This is the verb werken, and werken, if you chop off the en, you get werk. Well, that is in sexy soft ketchup, so we add t-e. Cool. Kennen, knowing. If you chop off en, you get ken with two n's. N is not in sexy soft ketchup, so you get kenden with a de. Now, the weird thing, okay, so first, why is this the case? Now, all the consonants in sexy soft ketchup are unvoiced consonants, the ones I mentioned before, where you don't use your voice box. T is an unvoiced consonant, and D is a voiced one. In Dutch, we like to put those together. That sounds better, we think. So werkten sounds better than werkden. That sounds a bit awkward. Werkden. And kenden makes more sense because the N is voiced and the D is also voiced. If you had kenten, it kind of works, but doesn't sound as good. Note, however, that this is for some reason about the crude stem and not the actual stem. So for some verbs like reizen, we saw that before, to travel, if you chop off en, you have reis with a z. That is the crude stem. The actual stem is reis. But the sexy soft ketchup rule applies to the crude stem and not the actual stem. So we have reis, which is not, the z is not in sexy soft ketchup. So we add ten. But the rule works like this. We have the stem and then we add ten. And the stem of reizen is reis with an s. So then we get reisten. And so we get reisden. So we do have this unvoiced voiced consonant. Very weird. But that doesn't happen that much. So in general, you can remember this if you like thinking about consonants like this. Unfortunately, not every verb works by this super simple rule with no exceptions. We also have irregular ones. Namely, these are some examples. Hebben, zijn, gaan, whatever. I have two things I can give you to make this a bit simpler. First is the separate from that is the hard advice. You just have to you just have to learn them. Unfortunately, there's no very easy way to learn all the irregular verbs. You just have to be exposed to them a lot. But there are two things you can do. First is you can know sort of that a verb is irregular in Dutch if it is irregular in English. Those two have quite a lot of overlap, like 70% or something, which is not perfect, but it's pretty good. So if you see a verb in Dutch and you know what it means and you want to know, ooh, is that irregular? And then you can think, oh, I know that verb in English because I'm fluent in English because I can hear Thomas speak right now. And then you know, ah, that verb is irregular. And so the Dutch word is also probably irregular. Probably you won't think about it like that, but maybe that automates a bit. The second thing is that these verbs follow a certain pattern. That is a bit complicated. It's like 11 different patterns. I put that thing in the slide, or I will put that on the files tab, and I think it is already in the general one. And you can see all the patterns for the verbs. So just like in English, there is some kind of pattern, like swim, swam, sing, sang. Is a sort of pattern, and in Dutch we also have those things, and that might be useful to know, but you have to figure it out yourself, unfortunately. Now we will speed through these last two things, and I will go on to the main exercise, the actual meat of the thing. Questions, very easy. You have a normal sentence, subject, verb, object. Ik eet te veel appels. I eat too many apples. I do. And you want to make a question, where you have, there's this intervention happening about your apple consumption, and you're like, nah, I don't know, ate too few apples? Do I eat too many apples? You just invert the subject and the verb. Unlike English, we don't need this helper verb, do. It's kind of weird that English does that. But in Dutch, we don't need it. So it's just inversion. Easy. We'll talk about this a lot in lessons 14 through 16, about word order. This slide just sucks. So sorry. You can see in your booklet, there's a list of question words. You just slap them in front of a question sentence. Bam, you got a more specific one. Very interesting. Or actually, no, it's less specific. It's more general. Just look in your booklet. It's fine. Then finally, this atrocious slide, I will never just convert it directly from slides again, don't worry. Demonstratives, they are kind of like definite articles, but they have a space dimension. Ooh, interesting. So in English, we have this and these for things that are close and singular and plural, respectively. And that and those for things that are far away and singular and plural, respectively. In Dutch, we don't distinguish between singular and plural, but between de and het, because we have that, you know? And all plurals are de words anyway, so. So in Dutch we have dit and dat for close things that are de and het, respectively. So de is dit and het is dat. And, sorry, I'm totally wrong. That is dit and deze, or deze and dit, for de and het, respectively. So deze is de, close, and dit is het, close. And then we have die and dat, for de words far away and het words far away. That is the distinction.
Yeah, so. Maybe a way to remember, deze and die end with an e, just like de. De also ends with an e. And het ends with a t, and dit and dat also ends with a T. So that's a way to connect, to know which one fits which.
It's a pretty good one. Nice. I didn't even think of that. Nice. Okay, so now armed with that knowledge, we are here again. And that was it for the recap, basically. So I want to give a little pause for any questions that might have arisen during this. If you want to, if something repeated quickly or something you didn't quite catch, let me know. Let us know. And if not, then we'll move on, but I'll leave a bit of space. Okay, I'm uncomfortable with the space. I don't see any questions. So we will move on to the final exercise. We have already assigned you into groups. And this is your assignment, if you're willing to accept it. Should you choose to accept it? Fuck, I fucked up the line. Okay. You're put into groups. The goal of the thing is to get to know each other a bit more. And what better way to get to know each other a bit more through some artificial game, which here is two truths, one lie, which you know. But the catch is you have to communicate all in Dutch, and you have to come up with two truths and one lie about your whole group. So, for instance, if you are all vegan for some reason, if that happens to be the case, then that could be a truth, or you could put it as a lie. So what is the goal of this? So you do it. Well, the goal is to get to know each other a bit better, but whatever. We come back. Everyone tells those things, and you will vote on which statement you think is the truth and or lie. Which statement is the lie. And then we look back, and everyone says, what is their lie? And we see which group has the least votes for their lie. And those are the winners. And they get a big old thumbs up from this guy, which is very rewarding thing. So yeah, that is the goal. If you think the voting is confusing, we'll get to that. That won't be the difficult part. If you think the exercise is confusing, please speak up now or forever hold your silence. So is the exercise clear? Let's try to be a bit less memey. Okay, cool. You will be put into groups. Starting now.
10 minutes, right? So 10 minutes.
Yeah, we'll give you 10 minutes.
Yeah.
Okay. Have fun. And we will occasionally drop by to stalk you. Okay, cool. It worked. Yay. Tijd is moeilijk, man. Oeh.
Okay, yeah.
Okay. Ik moet jou in dingen gooien om ze te bekijken. Dus welke kleur voel jij? Welke kleur voel je?
Kan ik er ook gewoon wel zelf uit? Of?
Nee, ik moet je eruit halen.
Doe maar, ga maar naar groen. Maar wanneer hou je me eruit dan?
Laten we 2 minuten doen.
Oké.
Okay. Zo'n 19 haal ik je eruit.
Is goed.
Ik kan jou in groen doen. Oké, doei.
Doei.
Yeah, you should be moving in a bit. Yeah, okay. No, it doesn't work like that.
Oké, daar ben ik weer.
Ja, oké. Je kan dus niet mensen uit de groep halen als die open is.
Oké.
Dat is erg lastig.
Oké. Ben jij nog langs geweest bij groep of niet?
Ja, ik ben bij groep blauw gegaan. En ze waren niet in Nederland aan het discussiëren. Dus ik, flinke vingers stik, nee. Ik vind het moeilijk om het niet ongemakkelijk te doen. Om bij mensen binnen te komen. Hey guys, I'm just kind of watching.
Ja, ik was gewoon van, begrijpen jullie de opdracht? En ik gaf een voorbeeld. Bijvoorbeeld, we wonen in Utrecht.
Dan gaat iedereen die doen.
Dat denk ik ook.
Ja. Maar ja. Ja, er moet even een betere manier zijn om...
Het zou fijn zijn als ze een hand of zo konden opsteken. Van, hey, ik heb een vraag, even hierin komen.
Ja, dan zouden ze, als ze iets niet snappen, misschien naar de general, dat één iemand van de groep eerder naar ons toe komt om een vraag te stellen.
Ja, maar je kan niet. Ik ga ze niet meer erin gooien, want ik ken jou. Jij zit ook nog steeds in die groep, als het goed is, staat er.
Oh.
Ja. Dus het werkt niet precies helemaal goed, maar nee. Goed genoeg. Nee. Ja, het is ook jammer dat je niet twee organizers kan hebben. Waarom zou jij dat niet moeten kunnen doen?
Ja, ook, ja. Raar.
Ach, ja.
Nou ja, op zich, het kan wel zo, maar...
Ja, het is beter dan niet.
Precies, ja. Maar moeten we nog een keertje langs gaan bij een groepje? Of,
Ja, maar ik kan jou niet bij een groepje in.
Dus. Nee, precies. Alleen jij dan, dus.
Ja, dus ik ga nog even
bij
Oranje langs.
Ja, is goed.
Zie zo.
Succes.
Team Oranje gaat wel goed.
Oké.
Okay. Nee, blijkbaar niks met elkaar gemeen.
Oh, dan wordt het lastig.
Ja. Wel leuk. Dat zijn ze in ieder geval wel even zoet mee.
Maar praat ze Nederlands?
Praat wel Nederlands, ja.
Oké, top.
Dus ik join de groep geel nog even. Oké, voor de rest gaat het wel goed.
Top.
Ik stuur nog even een announcement, dat is nog 1 week. 1... You got 1 minute.
Ik krijg ook alle berichten binnen van groep
1. Ja, ik ook. Dat is wel vreemd.
Nou ja.
Maar ja.
Wel grappig om te zien dat ze, wat ze dan nu hebben bedacht.
Mm-hmm. Nu kan ik alvast even de Kahoot aanzetten.
Ja.
Slim, anders dan ga ik er zo meteen weer mee kutten. WhatsApp hier. Ja.
Ik weet trouwens niet hoeveel. Ik heb volgens mij heel veel tijd per slide gedaan. Maar je kan gewoon op een gegeven moment skippen dan, denk ik.
Ja. Dat ben ik echt. Het is meer voor het gewoon goed stemmen. Maar je hebt maar 20 seconden per slide.
Dus. Oh, oké. Okay. Nou, dat is prima dan, denk ik. Want dan gaan ze eerst gewoon introduceren hun stellingen. En dan gaat iedereen gewoon stemmen, toch?
Ja.
Oké. Okay.
Kijk, share alvast mijn scherm. Include computer sound. Oké. Ik denk dat ik wel 1 minuut nodig heb gegeven. Nu ik zal het terug. Hallo. Hello, welcome back everyone. Hope you didn't mind our awkward intrusions. Wow, okay. Oh, okay. I'm very sorry for that. We're living. Welcome back. Hope you didn't mind our awkward intrusions too much. So this is how we'll do it. Please join this Kahoot room where you can vote on the questions. We will go by every single group and ask them, because I still have your groups open here. No, I don't. Yeah, I do. And I will ask you, one of the group members, to tell me there are two truths and one lie, and you can vote on the lie. And then later we will reveal all and see who is the best liar of the 17 of you. Dude. Hello, Kadri. Okay, I think we are pretty complete. So let us start with, I think I will first have to ask you before we start, otherwise I will immediately start and then you won't have any time to think. So let's start with Team Orange, which is Lucia Garcia Barola, Marina, Simona, and Gabriela, I think. Do we have multiple Gabrielas? I think that happens. There's Gabriela, but also the, I won't beat myself up by my Spanish. Okay, I will just point to someone. Simona, could you tell us your two truths and one lie?
Yeah, we wonen in Utrecht. We hebben geen huisdieren.
Mm-hmm.
En we houden van lezen.
Okay. Cool. Now you can vote on which one you think is the lie. So, wonen in Utrecht, geen huisdieren, en we houden van lezen. Wat is de leugen?
Ja, 1 is Utrecht, 2 is huisdieren, en 3 is lezen.
Uh-huh. Okay, so most votes were for 2. We will, you don't have to reveal, we will do the big reveal at the end. Otherwise, if you get beaten now, or if you win so decisively now, it won't be fair for the other participants. Or it won't be as exciting. Let's move on to group green. Ah, fuck, I clicked go already. Well, it doesn't matter. We have a spare one, so that's good. Groep Groen, which is Ariana Lopez, Jacob Schreuder, en Irene Arak Lopez. I think those are the things. Ariana, would you tell us your two truths and one lie?
Wij spreken Spaans.
Mm-hmm.
En wij studeren. Wait, I'm trying to remember. Wij studeren en wij wonen in Utrecht.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Okay, so one. Wij spreken allemaal Spaans, we studeren allemaal en we wonen allemaal in Utrecht. Wat is de leugen? 1, 2 of 3. All right. Ooh, it is tied between 1 and 3. Let's see. Okay, well, let's see. Okay, group number 3 is group yellow. Group geel is Marina Rappellini, or all the way around, Coleca, Lydia, and Filippo. Lydia, would you tell us your 2 truths and 1 lie?
We haven't de taak niet volbracht. We hebben niet genoeg gemeen gevonden. Mm.
All right, so you couldn't figure out anything you had in common. You're just so wildly different people. well, could you at least then tell us some things that you did not have in common that you might reasonably have so? Or one fun, yeah, you can get off scot-free with one fun fact.
We wonen niet alle in Utrecht.
Mm, all right, Coleca, you had a...
We hebben niet alle huisdieren. We spreken niet dezelfde spraken.
Talen.
Taak. Mm. Ik weet niet.
No worries.
We have someone who would like to say something.
Coleca?
Yeah.
Another one told the three things. It was Bovain. Zijn er allemaal in die 20 en iedereen spreekt Engels in Spanje en we allemaal wonen in Utrecht.
Mm-hmm. But it was already spoiled that the last one indeed was not true, unfortunately. But you did figure out more about each other, and that was the real goal, you know? The friends we made along the way, the real treasure. So we won't score you, but you're not kicked out of the course. That's the that's the real consolation. Cool. Oh, fuck, I clicked go again. Oh no, this is bad because there's 2 more groups left. Can I help? Well, we'll just do it manually. 1, 9, 3, I agree. Random voter. Oh, I did it again. okay, we'll just do the last one manually. Apologies. It is a real fascinating phenomenon that as soon as you start jump in front of a class, you instantly become a giant boomer. It's wonderful.
Skipped it, dan kan je denk ik. Nee, laat maar. Dat gaat niet meer lukken.
Nee. All right. Team Pink, groep 3. Anna Dirkswagen, Sarah Kalman en Alfonso Dimas Martins. That were you. Sarah, could you give us your 2 truths and 1 lie?
You both are.
Yes, of course.
Fantastic.
We zijn allemaal in de 20. Mm-hmm. We hebben een Europees paspoort.
Mm-hmm.
Wij spreken Spaans.
Mm-hmm. Good, good, good. All right. We'll just do this manually a bit. So, we'll do this by raising your hand. So, everyone who thinks the first one is a lie, but we zijn allemaal in de 20, please click the raise hand button. All right. 2 people. The second one, and please unraise your hand, dat ze allemaal een Europees paspoort hebben. Who thinks that'd be a lie? Raise your hand if you do. No? Okay. Zero people, or is there something wrong with my end?
Nee, vijf people, vijf mensen.
Okay, you count. This happens for some reason. Okay, then finally, ze spreken allemaal Spaans. Hoeveel mensen denken dat dat een leugen is? And please unraise your hand if you raised it already.
1, 2 mensen.
Okay, goed genoeg. Sorry for this painful process. But damn it, we'll finish the exercise. Finally, Team Blue, Team Blau, consisting of, this is a email name, Botka Agi. I don't think that was your name. I can't remember. Rieke Kruis and K.D. Priliani. There's only one name who I think, I'm pretty sure is the first name, Rieke. Could you tell us your two truths and one lie?
De eerste, we leven allemaal in Utrecht. De tweede, we zijn allemaal masterstudenten. Mm-hmm. En de derde, we spreken allemaal drie talen.
Ooh, a new one. Okay, so again, raise hands for Utrecht. If that is the lie. And Evelyn, if you could count.
Yeah. Twee keer.
Okay. For everyone is a master student, please raise your hand. And it goes for one, and it goes for two. I can't do the auctioneer thing, that's very hard.
Vier.
Cool. And drie talen.
Ook vier.
Ooh, okay. Okay, now finally we have come to the end and we can round up the scores. So get the field report. Field report. Come on. So question one. Team, that was team one. Team Oranje. First was, we wonen allemaal in Utrecht. De tweede was, we hebben geen huisdieren. En drie, we houden allemaal van lezen. What was the lie? Team Oranje.
It was the first one.
Ah, nice. So only four lie points. Very good, very good. That will serve you well. Next. I think that one was a failure. And then, yes. Team Groen, we spreken allemaal Spaans, we studeren allemaal, of we wonen allemaal in Utrecht. Welke was de leugen?
The second one.
Ooh, we studeren allemaal. That was only one point. Very, very good. Team Geel, I think that was still on here before. Oh no.
Nee, Geel die was er met de. Dat was een soort van foutje. Met,
ja.
Dus die hebben we niet gedaan.
Oh ja, inderdaad. Dat was die problem. Oké. Okay. Then, Team Pink. The second one was, we are all in the 20s. We are all European. We all have a European passport. And we all speak Spanish. Which one was the lie?
The first one.
The first one. All right. That is two lie points. Very good. Then finally, Team Blue. We all live in Utrecht. We all do our studying on our masters, or we all speak three languages. What was the lie?
That we are all master students.
Ah, okay. Four lie points. And it turns out the decisive victor is Team Green, with the lie that they are all students. So you're not all students. One of you or two of you are not. Could you elaborate on that? That was the hint.
Yeah, no? It was, Irene had the word for it. She's doing an internship, but she knows the Dutch word. What was it?
The Dutch word was, I wrote it. Sorry, wait a minute. Bredig. Bredig or something like this. Or bedig or...
Wasn't it stage?
Stage, yeah.
Stage. Yeah. Stage. Maybe. I don't know. Yes. Like, I've read so many words. I have to...
Very good. To okay, learn. Cool. Well, you win, so you earn a thumbs up. Good job. Very good job. Thanks, everyone, for sticking with this technological mess. Hope you did learn a bit about each other and refresh your Dutch knowledge a bit. Starting next week, we will be doing more actual Dutch learning. The theme of next week's lesson is politics, because the elections are the week after that. So we will be learning a bit about the Dutch political system, in case you don't know much about it, and we'll be learning about adjectives, and we'll be doing some political related exercise, which hopefully will be fun and we won't get too angry. Let's still try our best. I think we can. Yes, via Duolingo, the thing, if you signed up, I can't see yet how many people did, you'll get a prompt for two lessons you can complete, and then we'll be very happy. And next week you'll get different lessons. And we'll see how that works.
The phone numbers?
Yeah, laten we dat volgende week doen.
Okay.
Is all yeah. That was it for this week. Again, if you have any questions, you are always free to ask them via mail or on Teams. We hope you had fun. And we'll see you next week. Tot volgende week.
Bedankt, tot volgende week.
Bedankt, tot volgende week.
Doei.
Bedankt.
Doei.
Doei, doei.
Doei.
Doei, doei.
Bedankt. Fijne avond.
Fijne avond.
Doei.
Sorry, Thomas, before I go, I think this class was quite nice, but I think I'll stick with the beginner's class for fundamentals as well, just so that, I mean, this was fine, the level is okay, but I think it's more of like the pronunciations and like break the trying to speak in Afrikaans as opposed to speaking in Dutch. So learning the Dutch pronunciations and stuff would be best for me.
Okay, that's totally fine. Yeah. If you change your mind halfway through, you're always free to join this one again. But nice. I think that's a good idea, Andy. Good to start with a good base. Otherwise, definitely. You'll learn habits that are very hard to learn. That's very
good. Thank you very much for all the help.
Hope you have a good evening. Thanks for being here. Hope you have fun.
Bye.
Bye.
See you next week. Okay.
Okay, top. Dat ging best okay, toch?
Ja, ging best okay. Het is wel, het is altijd toch moeilijk met de tijd.
Ja. Maar ook omdat we nu natuurlijk heel snel er alles heen. Weet je, het was gewoon een herhaling. Dus ja, weet je.
Ja. Ja, het is inderdaad niet zo.
Nee, het is ook niet
uitgebreid
heel
als we zouden willen doen.
Ja, precies.
Gelukkig is de rest van de cursus is meer echt één onderwerp in heel veel detail bekijken. Het was oké. Ik denk dat we de volgende keer die Two Truths, One Lie oefening, mensen waren toch wel een beetje te basic. Ik dacht, misschien moeten we aanmoedigen om ze wat edgier te zijn met hun dingen. Van, we hebben allemaal een hekel aan katten.
Ik denk dat ze dat lastig vinden qua vocabulaire, dat ze de woorden ervoor niet weten.
Ja, inderdaad. Misschien is het ook gewoon een beetje te moeilijke oefening.
Misschien wel. Want ik weet, gaan we het elke week dan, is dat idee om het elke week te doen of niet?
Niet deze oefening, dat wordt snel saai. Maar wel elke week is er wel een grote oefening.
Ja, precies. Ja, ja.
Okay. Dus voor volgende week had ik nog niet echt die oefening in de leesding. In het ding. Je weet wel. In de manual. Maar wat ik wil doen is een oefening hebben waarin dat mensen haken hebben dat ze gewoon een kieswijzer doen. Want dat is een leesopgave.
Ja. Dat is heel goed. Ja, goeie.
Maar ik zat even te denken, hoe kun je de groepjes doen?
Misschien kan je maar dat ze van tevoren. Ja, het is misschien leuk een soort van discussie of zo over de. Of dat ze samen de kieswijzer invullen of zo.
Mm-hmm.
Dat kan misschien ook. En dat je dan. Zodat ze kunnen. Maar dan moet het niet te lang zijn, want het duurt wel heel lang om zo'n kieswijze in te vullen natuurlijk.
Het zijn 30 vragen.
Hè? Ja, en het zijn best wel lastige woorden soms ook. Maar dat ze misschien elkaar kunnen helpen of zo bij het... als ze een vraag niet snappen, alleen dan moeten we wel kortere vragen hebben. Een kortere ding, want hij is heel lang natuurlijk, 30 vragen.
Ja.
Ja, of je kan van tevoren gewoon, dat ze net van tevoren zelf... Of in de pauze of zo, dat is ook niet natuurlijk ook lastig.
Ja. Op zich, als we, ik meen, als we ze er 20 minuten voor geven, denk je dat dat te doen is?
20 minuten.
Kort 30 vragen.
30 vragen, ja. Het zijn wel een paar lastige woorden, tenminste. Ja, ik denk dat er misschien wel wat dingen tussen zit van, weet je wel, kerncentrales en dat soort woorden. Ik weet niet of ze dat helemaal begrijpen.
Ja, die is wel moeilijk.
Dat zijn wel moeilijke vragen hoor.
Maar ja, als je gewoon een deel van de... Ja, dat is, misschien dat ze iets aanleren van... Oh, als je binnen zoveel seconden niet snapt, dan door. Dus ik kan ze overslaan. Dat vind ik leuk.
Misschien is er
een kortere kieswijze ergens.
Ja.
Dat speel.
Ja. Ja, ik zal even zoeken. Dus volgens mij is er wel een kortere versie. Of een jongere editie sowieso natuurlijk. En die is volgens mij wat korter. Maar een studenteneditie.
Ja, of het gaat niet per se omdat het super accuraat is of zo. Maar...
Nee, precies. Maar ook dat het wat begrijpelijk is ook, denk ik. Dat ik moet kijken of je daar misschien wat meer... Weet je wel, misschien is het een beetje meer op het level is van middelbare schoolleerlingen die het beter begrijpen of zo. Misschien dat er zo'n stelling of zo beter...